came, he saw, he conferenced. Donald Trump tries to rally Republican leaders.
This is a process. It takes a little time.
Did he change any minds? His own thinking seems to be taking some surprising turns.
Total and complete shutdown of Muslims entering the United States.
Bernie Sanders says he hasn't been shut down.
We are in this campaign to win the Democratic nomination.
We are in Political Man.
Trying to keep track of Donald Trump's about turns. Hello and welcome. I'm Jonathan Mann, and this is Political Man. America's most surprising politician is surprising us again.
Donald J. Trump is calling for a total and complete shutdown of Muslims entering the United States.
Remember that? Trump said back in December he was explicitly calling for a ban on Muslims. This week, call for a ban? What call for a ban?
It hasn't been called for yet. Nobody's done it. This is just a suggestion.
That wasn't the only change we're seeing. The day Trump launched his campaign last June.
I'm using my own money. I'm not using the lobbyists. I'm not using donors.
Now he's hiring lobbyists to run his campaign and beginning a major effort to enlist donors to pay for it. And then there are his tax returns. For decades, U.S. presidential candidates have publicly released their tax records. Trump told Fox News he would too.
Hopefully before the election, I'll release, and I'd like to release.
This week, we learned from an interview with the Associated Press that he is not going to release his tax returns before Election Day after all. Trump says that he can't release them because he's being audited by the Internal Revenue Service. The IRS says he can make his returns public anytime he likes.
After his interview with the Associated Press, Trump said he'd been misquoted and will release his returns after the IRS audit is done. We'll keep you posted. There are all kinds of pressures on Trump, of course. Some of them are coming from Paul Ryan, the Speaker of the House of Representatives, the most powerful Republican in Washington, and a vocal skeptic in the top ranks of the party.
This is a process. It takes a little time. You don't put it together in 45 minutes.
The 45 minutes were the most highly anticipated meeting in Washington this week, a private session to find a way to bring the two men together after Ryan pointedly refused to endorse Trump. Ryan has insisted that Trump, whose policies are a big departure for a lot of mainstream Republicans, has to unify the party first.
I don't want us to have a fake unification process here. I want to make sure that we really truly understand each other.
Trump had meetings with other Republican leaders as well, but he is still waiting for Ryan's official endorsement and says he expects to get it.
Oh, I would think he would. And, you know, if that didn't happen, I would continue on the way I've really done. But we had a great meeting yesterday.
So let's talk the politics. Joining us now is Kevin Sheridan, former Republican National Committee spokesman and former communications director for Paul Ryan when Ryan was running for the vice presidency in 2012. Thanks so much for being with us. You know how these things are done. So let me ask you a very basic question. How surprising, how stunning really is it that Paul Ryan still isn't ready to endorse the presumptive nominee of his own party?
Well, Paul Ryan reflects what a lot of Republicans are going through right now. Republicans from both the conservative wing of the party, the mainstream, quote-unquote establishment wings of the party, are having a hard time coming behind the presumptive nominee because of many of the things he said, the scorched earth campaign that he ran, some of the policy positions that he has taken. So right now they're trying to figure out if there's enough common ground to come behind him, support him, run in on a unified-ish ticket in November. And so this is a process they've started, and we'll see how it plays out over the next couple of months.
What's the calculation? You know Paul Ryan well, you worked with him. What must be going through his mind, and if you can see into that, what would be going through the mind of Donald Trump as he's undertaking these kinds of negotiations?
Well, Paul Ryan was dealt some tough cards and given a number of bad options. He took the option to try to buy some space and time for his members of the House and the Senate who are running campaigns, and they don't want to be necessarily tarred with everything that Donald Trump has said or the positions that he's taken that are counter to their own. So I think he's trying to figure out if Donald Trump is going to change his tone, if he's going to settle on some specific positions, because he frequently changes them, that they can agree on, and that if they can't necessarily run as a very unified ticket that they can at least not attack each other, that they can steer clear of each other and run their own races, and he can run his. Donald Trump is, I wouldn't guess to venture what he's going to do. He's been very unpredictable to this point, but he's kept up momentum, and he's obviously got a sizable following right now.
You talk about how unpredictable he is and about how he changes his positions. He's been changing some big ones lately when it comes to how he's going to raise funds for his campaign or what he would do as president about Muslims, for example. What do you make of that?
I think this is just more of the same. He's been changing his positions throughout the primary. He's attempting to now pivot, I think, to a slightly more inclusive message or a general election message. He kind of flies by the seat of his pants, though, and he makes up policy as he goes along. So he's been successful in doing that in the Republican primary. It hasn't hurt him with his voters. We don't know yet, though, if that will affect general election voters. We don't know yet what that will do in the polls, and we're going to have to wait and see in the next couple of weeks how the polling comes out and what people are starting to think about his latest policy shifts.
Kevin Sheridan, thanks so much for this.
Thank you.